Boy, Dave and I just had a great uplifting conversation.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Positivity today.
Hello, everybody on YouTube, KLBJ FM channel, and on the Facebook. Appreciate that. Not a lot of exciting things to show you this morning. I did want to see what shortbread was. Sweetbread over in England. It is the thymus gland, or sometimes the pancreas of an animal, and it's used for food.
I love pancreas. Nice.
I couldn't bring myself to eat it when I was over in England.
Nice pancreas sandwich.
So next week we're going to have the heavy metal scream off, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to knock the crap out of that 105-year-old woman's record in the 100 meters, right?
You're going to kill her.
And since I'm going to get destroyed in the heavy metal scream off, I think y'all have to showcase my versatility by finally playing one of my my parodies, right? We got to do it.
No, let's do it. We can do it now because we're on camera and we can give you the looks of what we think.
That's true.
People
it's
can
true.
See our, okay.
So just warning, you know, I bleeped out a lot of profanity, but it's all bleeped.
It's 100%. It shook ones too.
Yeah,
we may have to.
But
I don't know.
The concept, my friend and I always thought it would be funny to write a cover of Shook Ones about how badass and gangster it is to read books. So it's a gangster rap about literature.
I have no reference to Shook Ones.
You might recognize it. It's a very famous classic.
I would not recognize it. All right, play it.
No, have you seen 8 Mile?
Have you seen 8 Mile, maybe?
If you've seen 8 Mile, you'd recognize it.
It's
the song that plays when it's when he's on the bus writing lyrics, I think. No, I don't remember.
I like to apologize to Mobb Deep right now. So
who? Yeah.
Mobb Deep. They're the,
it's
the
time.
Rap group.
Bye, everybody. It's time. I've become Sammy Allred. I'm going.
No.
Who?
Play some Sammy.
Just look up.
Sammy Allred.
By gosh, he straightened us out, didn't he?
Sammy Allred was this redneck guy in a band called the Geese and Slaws, and he started radio way back when, and he's with Bob Cole, and I don't know how it all ended, but he's dead now. But he... It just became a slow talking talk show. It was very popular.
Well, we like to talk. We'll talk all day long.
And then he went to this small radio station that didn't have much of a signal. And that was it for him.
Top of the morning, but although it's not morning still.
I've noticed myself saying Sammy Allred type things, just in general. And now I'm going to hear a parody of a band that I've never heard of. That was in the movie 8 Mile about Eminem that I've never seen.
Are there any words in this?
I bleeped them all out. There were lots, but I spent a good deal of time bleeping them all out.
Let's hear it. This has got to be horrendous.
Please don't say filthy words on our program, please. I'm calling you out on that.
Okay. Just look that up. Yeah. I think that should bring it.
I almost want to pretend not to find it. Let me look it up.
So what was the original... Okay,
make sure you do clean edit.
For the parody part, what was the song originally about?
It's just, general gangster-ish. You know what I'm saying? It's just a gangster anthem.
Going to the club.
There's no such things as halfway crooks.
Okay.
You scared to death, you scared to look, you shook, because there ain't no such things as halfway crooks.
Okay, and this is a parody, which should only be a minute and a half long.
All right.
Go.
I hope it's the
hold up, say word.
Edited version.
It is. Does it say clear? Yeah, that's the only version in there.
Yo, pass me my bookmark. Yeah, give me the bookmark real quick. Shit, gotta keep my place. Well, I teach these fools a lesson. Check it out now.
Put the camera.
Here we go.
Put the camera on Dave to see him.
Take it off me. I don't want any part of this.
Swinging to the library, your boy behind the wheel. Got 20-inch blades on my bookmobile. Put your in the back, put the pedal to the metal. Got a problem with that, this shit's about to get settled. Your mark is tricking, your girl's a whole ass. The straight true, ain't no metaphor. And I be hanging out the side, cussing, busting through roadblocks. You already defeated in this, the damn prologue.
Don't miss words.
My statement's declarative, and I'm about to... And your narrative. And you
motherfucker. Kill it.
No, listen to the second verse.
No,
the
one. He's like bars, son. You don't want to see that second verse.
The music was fine. I don't get this. I don't know the song. But
so you don't
it looks like you could do a song parody, but I don't know if that's funny or not.
It is. Trust me. It's very, very funny. I'm hilarious.
He wants you to know.
I nailed it. It's great. Let's move on.
All right. Now you could do parody songs about Bob.
I'm just saying that anything. The only rap song we've played was that one ever on this show.
Yeah. I would take a...
Ain't no such things as half-read books, son.
You could take the thing with the boomer thing that we've done and write a song. I mean, write a parody song.
Yeah.
And you know, I could help you with the insults towards
Let's
Bob.
Let's do it. Yeah.
You know, throw in Kendra Scott, that he dated her and dumped her.
Oh, that's all mean.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. That's what I was saying the other day. We should write a parody rap song, and I'll spit it.
All right, let's stop it.
Don't say spit it.
Man, you corny!
Let's go.
All right, let's go back to the phones and see if people still like Dave.
Oh, they're going to love it.
All right, Fast Food Fanatics, let's go.
Oh, right now?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
All right. There is a Christmas food product that I have to fight not buying every year and drinking the entire thing either with liquor or without. Can you name what that is?
Eggnog. I'm going to go with it.
Dude, I freaking love eggnog.
Is it because it's delicious?
Yes.
So don't give me S about drinking fruity drinks throughout the year. I mean, you can do it seasonally. And your masculinity only has seasons?
I usually don't put alcohol in it. I don't want to ruin the eggnog with the alcohol taste.
Okay, so it's just a delicious drink.
Right. Oh, dude, I could drink one of those half gallons. I swear to God, I could. Well, this year, why don't you try Ranch Nog?
Ranch Nog.
Yeah, I hope this is just a joke. Hidden Valley's Ranch Nog.
Oh no!
Is made the most unholy of nogs. All right. Hidden Valley Ranch seems to get away with more than other brands. Granted, they literally invented ranch dressing, which comes with plenty of goodwill. But also the idea of slathering any and everything in ranch is equal parts gross and engrossing. So when the brand launches promotions like Christmas stockings full of ranch or a lifetime supply of dressing, the glutton inside us chuckle with glee. Along those lines, Hidden Valley has continued to find strange items to sell in their own online shop, of course. Over Halloween, they did something. So what do they have in store for you? Ranch-soaked eggnog.
I could see myself drinking this maybe with some pizza, because I'll put ranch on my pizza.
That'd be a good
pairing. Have you ever just been drunk and when you're single and just like go up to the fridge and drink some nog?
I don't think I've ever had eggnog before.
Really? Never.
No.
You haven't had eggnog?
Mm-mm.
Oh man, it's
that's why I asked. Like, is it delicious?
Cream. It's like ice cream.
It's incredible.
Really?
Yeah, like melted ice cream.
Yeah.
All right.
Have I discussed this also? What is it that you cook and there's sauce left in it? Why is it ethically not right to just drink the sauce out of the bowl or off the plate?
Who's stopping you from doing that?
You mean ethnically?
I mean, you can't do that at a table. You know, you can't just slurp it all up. What was I talking about recently where you did that?
No idea.
Something's left behind. Oh, like a steak sauce that they do at a high-end restaurant. Why can't I just pick it up and drink the rest of it?
I don't think there's anything wrong, but you're supposed to dap it up with some bread. I think that's the main thing. That's why they give you bread.
You don't dap things up in bread at nice restaurants, I don't think. Oh. Here are the best cities for fast food, according to some people who do this kind of thing. Let's see here. Fast food's come a long way. Lawn Starter ranked 2022's best cities for fast food lovers to help you celebrate Fast Food Day, which was on the 16th. We compared nearly 200 of the biggest cities based on fast food restaurants and food delivery services. We also weighed the quality of the food based on consumer ratings and Thrillist Fasty Awards. All right, here we go. You want the city rankings? Here we go. Orlando, Florida is number one for fast food.
That makes sense, I think.
Houston, number two.
That definitely makes sense. Phoenix. Houston's the fattest city in the country.
Chicago, Las Vegas. And then Austin's at number 10.
I would not have thought Phoenix.
Why not?
I don't know why. Or Austin. I thought
instinct.
Austin was like a healthier city, but I guess we have a lot of fast food.
They
still.
Don't really describe how they came up with this list, though. I mean, it seems...
Highlights. What is burger up with Texas? The Lone Star State is all over the map in our ranking. Houston came in at number 2, Austin number 10, San Antonio 14th. On the other end, Laredo ranked dead last. Why the disparity? Quality is key. The larger Texas cities fared well in this category. At Houston, number one, Houston, and Austin, number 16. Okay, why? Because we have Whataburgers. But everywhere in the state, you're sure to find Whataburger, a regional chain founded in Corpus Christi with a huge fan base. Okay, I don't know what that means. Just to say that we have a lot of Whataburgers.
People really got upset when that Chicago company bought the Whataburger.
Well, I guess the thing? We're scared of change, Dave, and
I really am.
Especially when it comes to our burgers here in Texas.
You were really obsessed with food, dude. It's pretty amazing.
It's the giver of life. I don't know. It's helped us evolve.
The
giver of life.
Yeah.
Crotch is unzipped.
I mean,
Taco Bell's giving away festive Friendsgiving party packs. Okay. What? And they come with, it looks like, chocolate stuff and some other stuff.
What? Oh, other stuff.
Yeah. Friendsgiving season is in full swing, and if you're scrambling to find the perfect dish to bring to your pal's table, Taco Bell may have your back. The fast food chain made a limited number of super festive, food-filled Friendsgiving party packs for loyal customers. Here's the way this works. They come out with a limited number of these things, and dumb radio personalities fall for it as content. And so they get the word out there so that all this stuff will sell out. All right. Each pack includes ready-to-heat Taco Bell-inspired recipes, each of which come in a reusable branded baking dish. Lucky Taco Bell fans who are able to get their hands on a Friendsgiving party pack will also get a Friendsgiving decor to jazz up their gathering.
Jazz.
Okay. All right.
There's some moth just like flew by.
Yeah.
I think it came out of my wallet or something.
Popeyes has come up with a new mac and cheese. No, they haven't. Home style mac and cheese.
What?
Popeyes.
They should have. Every place with chicken, I think, should have some mac and cheese. Hot take.
Well, where'd my sounds go? Not that one.
Nope.
Are my hotkeys not working again? Nope. Let's try that one with it. That's always this one here, then. There you go. Epic sound.
Okay.
What was your statement again?
Mac and cheese should be served at every chicken place.
Okay.
Revolutionary thought.
JJ Barbecue in Cedar Park. Standalone, not a chain, right?
Mm-hmm.
They serve a burger, and they cover the entire plate over the burger with cheese.
With cheese?
Yeah, but that's not the standout thing. They do fried okra by the big box.
I'm not a big fried okra fan.
I love fried okra.
I think we just end the show right now.
I'm sorry. I don't.
Fried okra?
Love it.
The snot's all gone from it. You like pickled okra?
Mm-mm.
He likes it with the snot.
I don't know. I guess, yeah, that's one I don't like. That's okra I do not like. But Merino Barbecue, I'm coming for your burger. That looks good.
Oreo thins are on the way. Why?
I feel like that's already been done. I feel like I've seen that.
It's
years
Oreo
ago.
Thins, but it's extra stuff.
It's extra lard.
Oh, so the ratio.
It can't be lard still.
It's lard or whatever. It's fat with sugar in it. That's all it is.
Mm.
While Oreo has been debating the perfect cookie to cream ratio, the engineers have been hard at work developing a new adult-friendly option for everyone who loves the crisp snap of Oreo thin wafers, but desires a bit more cream.
What is an adult?
I hate it. Immature we are. I think it's good. I like. Well, no, I like a regular double stuff with some a glass of milk.
My wife has these two jars, and she stacks the regular Oreos and the vanilla Oreos.
Jemima jars.
Sitting out. No, they're clear, and they're sitting out, and they have to be perfect. I can't eat Oreos. I'll eat 70 of them, and I just go by there every day and go, why did she torture us like this?
I have no idea. I feel like you're supposed to like have a candy dish or a cookie jar in your house. I stay away from that.
My sister has a cookie jar you can borrow. All right. Asian man in China.
I'm upset about this.
Got banned from an all-you-can-eat barbecue place for eating too much.
What?
We used to have a drop-in. The guy goes, "Oh, you eat too much." Was that from what movie? Was that from?
I don't know, but I'm not gonna play it. I think this reminds me of a Simpsons episode. Does this look like a man who's had all he can eat?
A Chinese food live streamer says he's been blacklisted from a grill buffet restaurant for eating too much. The man, known only as Mr. Kang, told Hunan TV that he was banned from the Handidi Seafood Barbecue Buffet in Changsha after a series of binges. He ate 1.5 kilograms. Who can translate that?
I think that's like 3.2 pounds. I don't know.
That sounds about right.
Of pork trotters during his first visit and 3.5 kilograms to 4.4 kilograms of prawns. That would be shrimp. On another visit, Mr. Kang said
3.3 pounds.
Yeah, you nailed it.
The restaurant is discriminatory against people who can eat a lot.
Those poor overeaters.
I can eat a lot.
I mean, come to America where you belong, sir. Get over here.
I think I've read stories over the years of people being cut off on all-you-can-eat restaurants.
I feel like I've read stories of people suing restaurants for false advertising when that happens.
They're not doing it now in the Cedar Park Jack Allen's, but the one in Round Rock, they do a morning breakfast buffet.
At Sirloin Stockade?
No, at Jack Allen's.
Oh, Jack Allen's.
Mm-hmm. You cannot, it's decadent as hell. Dude.
I mean, Golden Corral, too. They got
You cannot compare.
Mexicans out there, they got menudo. It ain't
you
bad.
You can't compare Golden Corral to Jack Allen's.
I will.
No, you won't.
Now, I feel like I could probably take out a Jack Allen's, you know, food-wise.
Have you eaten at Jack Allen's?
Yeah, yeah. Okay. They had that good biscuits and gravy. Their gravy was like a brown chorizo gravy
Chicken fried steak. I mean, a real steak, steak.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
I used to love Shoney's when I was a kid.
I'd have to be on heroin to go to Shoney's.
Runny eggs and such.
You know, as a kid, we never went to a nice restaurant. Not once. Can't remember ever going
Real. You want to know this? I don't even know. Maybe there was some significance.
My dad believed that a nice restaurant was Furr's Cafeteria. That's what we would do.
My grandparents had an anniversary and got a limo and went to Joe's Crab Shack in Round Rock.
Yeah, your mom. What did your mom want to go to?
Olive Garden would probably be like...
Olive Garden's just fine with her.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I offered to take her to like some really nice places, and she does not...
But if she wants a lot less food that costs so much more money, take her to Wink.
What is Wink?
Wink, pretty much, it's really a good restaurant. It's highly rated. But Wink pretty much tells you how much food you're going to be getting.
Aww.
It's like a little thing comes out.
But I like those. Like, you took me to Barley Swine, and I think they're the same places. Like, Odd Duck, I really love, because it's always interesting combinations and seasonal foods.
Yeah. God. Bob and I went to the Golden Corral?
Yeah.
Once, and we saw a kid drop a... roll on the ground. I'm not joking. He and his mother and the other kid were barefoot, and they didn't notice it, and the roll kept just being hockey pucked around. And then somebody finally sees it and put it back up.
Oh no.
And we just sat there, and as people came to the restaurant, who do you think, who's gonna get it? And these firemen came in, and one of them picked it up, and we...
Did you save him? Or did you watch him eat it?
No, we watched him eat it.
That's despicable. Despicable behavior, Dale.
You pretty watched a murder happen, pretty much.
Yeah. We watched him eat it. It was golden at the Golden Corral. All right. When was the last time you ate at a Golden Corral?
It's had to have been like less than a year, maybe.
See, that's what I'm worried about my life, being single, 60, there's nowhere to go.
It doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter anymore.
I've leaned into it.
This is why I've really been considering taking myself out. Just the idea, you know.
Now, why does the weight not matter?
Who am I going to date at 60?
Somebody.
No.
You've got plenty of matches on Tinder.
There are other 60-year-old men.
After being with a gorgeous woman all this time? No, I mean.
Well, yeah.
We're fine. It's just the idea of it. Just scares the crap out of me. How much does a big thing of helium cost? Because I hear that's the way to go.
It would be a hilarious way to go out.
There's so many people out there.
Especially if you took last-minute phone calls.
Hello?
No, you're never going to talk me out of this.
Goodbye, cruel world.
And finally to my family.
man.
We didn't mean to make suicide fun.
It's coming full circle, though.
Yeah.
That's how we started things off today.
All right, let's see what else I got here before we go. We did that.
List of the funniest suicides of all time.
Oh, which one do I want to do?
Like that one.
Oh, that's not fast food
fanatics.
Let's
save that for later because I want to know.
Austin Restaurant got a big award.
Which one?
I don't know. I haven't read it. Esquire magazine names Austin Restaurant in a list of best new restaurants in America.
Oh, look at that.
Hestia.
I've always wanted to go Hestia.
Hestia is the one.
I need to go.
Kevin Franken, another dude, gave it a glowing review, calling it the city's most ambitious restaurant and granting it a 9 out of 10 rating. I wonder what Carrie Ann Sanaba thought. Right. I'm having to be nice. I've been watching Dancing with the Stars.
Oh, man, I'm so sorry, bro. That's a new
there's
low.
There's this one British dude, after everyone dances, he goes, Your play was wonderful. And you hugged and you made your moves. There was no space between this time. And like I told you before, keep your shoulders up. Gayest thing you've ever seen.
He's very enthused.
On fire.
And there's nothing wrong with it.
Yeah. He's the only entertaining thing on that show.
Yeah,
I don't know why she likes that. Maybe because I never danced with her.
You get to judge other people on something that you probably won't do either.
Yeah.
The people like judging.
Well, they finally have two girls on it dancing with each other.
I mean, if we're going to congratulate people for judging meat, then why can't we be with people judging dancing?
And then here, you want Arby's vodka or 3D printed steak?
We've done Arby's vodka.
Yeah, yeah.
So 3D printed steak, I'm all for the future.
Yeah.
As long as it tastes like it. I've been warming up to Beyond Meat.
This is a video of them. So there it is, being cooked.
It doesn't
and
look like
at
steak.
That. Ugh. Fat, blood, and muscle, but that's not real steak. That's not real fat, blood, and muscle.
So appetizing seeing it come out of the...
Is it fake meat? Well, I don't have the audio up on the damn machine.
Of course, I don't know.
It
looks like the stuff they make Twizzlers out of.
But it's not real meat, right?
They're testing the...
Nutritional yeast and coconut fat is formed into steak-like shapes
using
a 3D printer.
It looks like that dog food when they try to make it look like
Bacon strips is what it looked like. It looked like bacon strips.
I wonder what the Texas Tech team would think of that stuff.
I've heard they've come a long way with these fake meats, though. Uh-huh. I really like that some of them are really good.
I'm the largest meat company in the world just by harnessing technology instead of animals.
Meat substitutes are not new, but unlike the soy-based crumbles that mimic ground beef, Redefine Meat's product is designed to act, taste, and cut like flank steak.
This is the holy grail of alternative.
I'd like to try that.
Me too, actually. That doesn't look bad.
Try it and then give the rest to my cat, but...
All right. What if you loved it?
I don't
know.
Might love
it.
Very small
Thank
chance.
You, everybody on cameras. We appreciate you listening, and we appreciate you tuning in on Fridays and Wednesdays most of the time. I want to tell you about
Dudley and Bob in Studio is brought to you by Tecovas, providing top quality Western boots and accessories online at tecovas.com, and by Renegade Truck Accessories, your source for truck caps, bed covers, lift kits, and custom services online at renegadetruck.net.